What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be showing you six cool iPhone settings that you can change. All you have to do is fiddle around with the settings and you'll have it right there. Let's get started. One, which is the coolest one that I'm sure a lot of people are aware of, but I can show you a deep dive into it, is going to be the iOS 16 update, where you can change your own custom wallpaper. As you can see, this is by another app called Widgie, which I showcased in another video. If you want to see that one, it's going to be on this card right here. But let's get started. You just hold, press this down, and there you go. See, I already have some presets. But let's say you want to start a new one. All you have to do is add new wallpaper right here. They give you a bunch of feature ones. So if you don't want to, you can just click one of these here. As you can see, Photo Shuffle is a new selected option that I'm going to go over right here. As you can see, you can add your own photos, photo shuffle, emoji, weather, astronomy, color. Let's go to photo shuffle. It's really cool because I have some nature photos that are custom made, and you can do nature. Now, shuffle frequency, you can do hourly, on tap, on lock, or daily, which is really cool. So let's say I wanted to use these photos, or you can select them manually, just like that. These are going to change every hour, and it's going to be really sick. You can change the background color, color wash, duotone, black and white, natural. You can shuffle the categories. You can shuffle the frequency, show photo in library, don't feature photo, cancel, add. You can add just like so. You can even edit the home screen, which I'll show you right here. You can blur, unblur it, add your custom gradient or color or a different photo. But we'll keep it like that. Now focus, you can have ones that are specifically for us focus. Let's say I wanted to do not disturb. So whenever my phone's on do not disturb, it's gonna go to this specific wallpaper. Now if I wanted to edit it again, you just hold it like so. Customize, lock screen. You can add your own widgets here. You can see there's specific apps like Duolingo, Fitness, Gmail, Google, Health, and all these things, which are really cool, which expands your horizon for how much you want to customize your phone. I really enjoy this update. It's revolutionary because Android has been prone to being known for customization, which Apple has been strict on. But now with this update, it looks really cool. You can shuffle your photos at any given time. And I just think it's a really cool update. The second settings change that you can do is going to be called Auto Live Captions, which is in its beta stage, which you can just do for FaceTime or you can do for every single app. Now all you got to do, go to settings, scroll down, go to accessibility, scroll down again until you see subtitles and captioning. Right below, it's going to be Live Captions Beta, just like that. Gives you options of live captioning, or if I turn this mic on and I speak right now, there you go. It's listening and picking up my audio and putting it into text. Now I can pause it. I can shorten it into a little small bubble in my phone. I can expand it. And you can add it to FaceTime. Turn this off so you can just have it in FaceTime. And you can even change the appearance of it. You can have bold, text size, text color, background color, reset it, ideal opacity, and all these really cool things and features which you can have at a click of a button. Now a third setting you can change is changing your text size in the specific app or all of it. So you're going to go yet again to settings. You're going to go over here to control center, and then right here, these are the controls that you can find by swiping down left on your iPhone. Right here I have a pre-selected ones right here. One of them is going to be called text size. And if you click it on here, it gives you the example, default, all apps, settings only, which is really cool. I thought you can only do it for all the apps. So let's say I go to Spotify and I wanted to increase the size for Spotify only, which I already put for 90. Say I wanted 190. See how big the text is? Yet if I go here, everything else is the same. Let's say I wanted the text size to be default for all apps. Let's say I go back to Spotify. It's still big because I still didn't specify in the app all size. So as you can see here, I'm gonna keep it like this. And there you can customize each app with how big or small the size you want, which is really cool. Now, a fourth thing you can change on your phone is turning off precise locations on your specific app. For me, I don't like certain apps to know my specific location. So you can go to settings, go to privacy and security. After going to location services, right here, I'm gonna scroll down to maps. As you can see, precise location, obviously for the maps, they need my precise location. But for certain apps like Instagram, I'm turning that off. Google, Snapchat, of course, Snapchat. All these apps, which I'm really iffy about sharing my exact location with, I can turn it off like so. Now, a fifth really cool setting change that you can do is called back tap. Now, go to your settings app, go to accessibility, go to touch. Scroll all the way down until you see back tap right here, which it is on. You can edit your double and triple tap. So for me, I put camera, but you can choose anything from the system, accessibility, even your own custom shortcuts, which is really sick. So without further ado, let's double tap and see what happens. There you go. Just like that, I double tapped it. Now let's see if I put triple tap for flashlight. That is really cool. Triple tap it again. Turn it off. Double tap it. Turn the camera. That is a really cool feature that you can have. All you got to do is double tap it or triple tap it, and you'll instantly do something to your own benefit. Now the final setting that you can change on your iPhone is with allowing access when locked. Now go to your settings app. Go to face ID and passcode. Then you go here, scroll down, and allow access when locked is that you can do these functions on your iPhone even when the phone is locked, such as wallet, accessories, reply with message, Siri, locked screen widgets, and all these things, which are really cool. It says unlock iPhone to allow accessories to connect when it has been more than an hour since your iPhone was locked. So it gives you a time limit, but overall, that is a really nice feature that the iPhone allows you to have. Now, those are six really cool settings that you can change on your iPhone. Let me know if that helped. Make sure to subscribe, like, and comment on anything that you want to add, anything that you took away from this video. But overall, thank you guys so much for watching, and have a great day.